guys, welcome to DTW GED Prep. Okay, so in today's video, I'm going to be treating multiplication. Okay, I've treated addition, subtraction, and now this is multiplication. And after multiplication, I'm going to be doing division. And I'm doing this with several examples, okay, and several GED practice examples, okay. So if this is your first time on this channel, okay, please try to click the subscribe button and the notification bell. Please support this channel to grow. Quite a baby channel. Please support us to grow as we support you in getting your GED, and also give this video a thumbs up and share with your friends, family and loved ones trying to prepare for their GED test. And don't forget too that Jesus loves you. He is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. And he's saying to you today that you should come to him, okay? Give your life to Christ, for in him you find eternal life, you find peace, and you find joy. Alright? So he's waiting for you. Alright, so let's get on to the video now, which is on multiplication. So you know, multiplication, what's multiplication all about? So it's all about combining the same amount multiple times. Let's say for instance you have 50 and 50, you have another 50, you have another 50, you have another 50, you have another, let's say 50 even in 20 times or in 10 times, okay? And they said find the combined amount of 50. You know, for this, if you use the addition, you have to, you know, the way I explained addition, add them up. You have to arrange them like this and add them up. All right, so it's going to be quite long, okay? Very long column. So how do you simply do this? How many 50s do we have here? We have 7 50s. So that's where multiplication comes in handy. So all you need to do is just say 50 times what? 7. And it will give you the total combined amount. Okay. And how do we do this? Let's do 50 times 7. So this is the way you arrange it. All right. So we have here 7 times 0 is what is 0, okay, and we'll put down our 0, and 7 times 5 is what, 35, and we'll drop 35. This is how you multiply, okay. And I always advise students, before you go in for your GED test, your math test, please make sure you know your times table by heart. Okay, your multiplication times table is very, very paramount. You know it by heart, because almost all the questions, almost every question, you need the knowledge of your multiplication times table. So it's key that you know how your multiplication times table and also how to multiply. Okay, so let's do some example. And sometimes in some questions that they would ask, find the product of here we have 1, 3, 1, and 3. Okay, so this product just means you should what, multiply the two numbers. Okay, that's what this word means. So in word problems you might see this particular word, all right, to find the word product. So it means multiply these two numbers. So we arrange in multiplication, I always prefer students to start with the bigger number. So we have the bigger number here, then times the smaller number. We arrange it, just put this down here, okay. So let's multiply. We have 3 times 1, okay, you start from the value on your right. Okay, 3 times 1 is what, 3, and 3 times 3 is what, 9, and 3 times 1 again, we have a 3. So this is the answer for this. Okay, so let's do some more examples. Let's say we have 1, 4, 1 times what, 5. All right, so we have here 5 times 1 will give us what, a 5. And 5 times 4, what is 5 times 4? That's 20. So here, when you have something that is above 9, okay, when you multiply and it's above 9, you can see here we have 3 times 3, we just drop down the 9. But when the value becomes maybe 10, 11 or upwards, okay, you first of all, like this is 4 times 5 is what, 20. So we drop down the 0 and we carry this 2. You just hold on to the 2 first of all. Okay, don't go adding the 2 to the 1, all right, to make it 3, then you say 5 times the 3 becomes 15. No, okay, just keep the 2 upward here. Then first of all, multiply. 5 times 1 is what? 5. And then you now add this 5 to what, 2, which will give us what? 7. Okay, so this is how you drop down the 7. So this is how you want to multiply. Let's do something more. Let's do one more again. We're going to do several examples, so don't be worried, all right? So we have 2, 3, 0, 6 times, okay, 230 times 6. Okay, so here 6 times 0 is still what, a 0. Okay, and what is 6 times 3? Is an 18. Remember, as I said, 18. So you drop down an 8 and you carry a 1. Let this 1 just be somewhere here. Then you first of all say 6 times 2, that's a 12. Then you add the 12 to what, to this 1 here, which becomes what, 13. So you drop down 13. So this is the answer for this. Now let's do something more difficult. We're told to find the product of 46 and 52. Okay, so here let us arrange now. All right, so product of 46 and 52. So we have here the 46, then we have what, 52. Okay, so we drop our sign here. So we have our 46. Okay, so we have here, so this, since that same place value, I choose to put 46 first. But if there were different place values, okay, the bigger place value, I would prefer to put up. Okay, upward. All right, so you can see the way I arrange this, 46 here, then I drop my 5 here and my 2 here. Okay, this to help me, you know, break down my values well. Okay, or you can also, you can arrange this way, 46 times 52, you can make them be on the same line. But sometimes I see this method might confuse some people when they want to start multiplying. But if you use this, it's quite easier. All right, so all we need to do is start with 2. If you arrange it this way, it's quite easier. So all we need to do is start with 2. So we'll say here 2 times 6. What's 2 times 6? That's a 12. So we'll put down a 2 and we carry 1, don't forget. 2 times 4 is what, 8. Then we'll add this 8 to 1, we have what, a 9. Okay, now this is a two-step multiplication. All right, so here we have 5. Now the next value here, we started from our right to the left. Okay, so next value here is 5. So 5 times 6, what is 5 times 6? Is 30. You come down to the second digit here to your left and drop your what, 0. You know, remember 5 times 6 is 30, so drop your 0 and keep your 3 here. So we then say 5 times 4, which is what, 20. And we add this 3 to 20, which will give us what, 23. So we'll drop this down, 23. Okay, then we draw our line here. And here we have to now add up these two numbers here. So here we now have to perform what, addition. So we have here 2, there's nothing here, that's 2 plus 0, so it will be a 2. Here we have a 9 plus 0, that will give us a 9. And here we have, there's nothing here, there's just 0 here, so it's a 0 plus 3, which will give us a 3, and a 0 plus 2, which will give us what, a 2. So this is how you perform what, your products, you multiply, alright? Okay, and let's do another example so you get this. So let's say we're told to multiply 423, okay, by what, 36. Okay, so let's leave it this way also. All right, you know, this one I arranged, I told you this would be a better way, but let me also do this way so you understand both ways. Okay, so we're to multiply this. All right, so here we start with 6. Don't forget, start with the number to your right. So 6 times 3, that will give us what, 18. So we'll drop down a 8 and carry what, a 1. Alright, then 6 times 2 is 12. Then you add 12 to 1, that will be what, 13. So we drop down a 13, since it's greater than 9, and carry another 1. And 6 times 4, what is 6 times 4? That is 24. And 24 plus 1, that will give us 25. So we drop down what, 25. Now the next step, we have 3 times 3, which is 9. You drop your 9 under the second digit, okay, of this first number, okay? So we have 9. 3 times 2 is what, 6. We drop down 6. And what is 3 times 4, which is what, 12. So we drop down what, 12. Here, there's no need to carry anything since we don't have any number here. So we just drop down 12. And don't forget, we are adding these two numbers, okay? So we add them up. We put our plus sign here. So here, we drop down at 8, that's 8 plus 0 here. It's very important here how you arrange the next number underneath it. You must always leave a, you go to the second digit. Oh, don't worry, we're going to see another 3-step multiplication. You know, all these are just 2 steps, okay? And you know when it's 2-step, when what the multiplier is just 2 numbers. So this is what 2 steps, you're going to have 2 steps. Don't worry, you'll see what I mean. I mean very soon. So here we have 3 plus 9, which is 12. So we'll put down a 2 and carry this one. You add this 1 to 5, which is what 6, and 6 plus 6 is what 12. So we'll drop down a 2 and carry another 1 here. 1 plus this 2 here, that's 3. And 3 plus 2 is what 5. So we have 5 here. Okay, so here we have 0. Alright, so that's 0 plus 1. And we'll drop down our 1. So this is the answer for this. Multiply by this. Okay, now let's do a 3-step multiplication. So here we have 189 times what? 114. Okay, you can leave this arrangement like this, or also you can leave it this way, 19114. Okay, it's still the same. All right, but I said I always prefer students to arrange this way so they don't get confused in, you know, using each number. You know, some way I see where this confuses some students in using this is they start with 1 to multiply. You always have to start from the number on the far right. That's what you start with. Okay, so we do this. Let's use this. So we have 4. I wanted to get used to this. Okay, so we have 4. 4 times 9 is what? 36. We'll put down a 6 and we'll carry that 3. What is 4 times 8? It is what? 32. And 32 plus what? 3. That's 32 plus 3 will give us what? A 35. So we drop down a 5 and carry what? A 3. Okay, this is 35. So we drop down 5, carry 3. Then 4 times 1 is what? 4. And what's 4 plus 3? That will give us what? A 7. So this is the first line. This is the first step. Now the next digit now we have to use to multiply. So we have 1 times 9 is what? Remember, as I said, in arranging, you start from the next digit. Okay, so 1 times 9 is what? 9. And 1 times 8 is what? 8. And 1 times 1 is what? 1. Okay, so for the next step, we have 1 times 9. You come now to, you can see how what's going on. So for the next, the third step, 1 times 9 is 9. You come down here, you leave the next this last digit to the second what digit to towards your what, your left. Okay, so here we drop down 9, and 1 times 8 is 8 still, and 1 times 1 is 1. Then we do a plus. We're adding up all this together, so we have 6. We'll drop down at 6. What is 5 plus 9? 5 plus 9 will give us what? A 14. So we drop down 4 and carry this 1 here. So 1 plus 7 is what? 8. And 8 plus 8 is what? 16. And what is 16 plus 9? That will give us what? A 25. So we drop down a 5 and carry this 2 here. So 2 plus 1 is 3, and 3 plus 8 is what? 11. So we drop down this 1 and carry this 1, and 1 plus 1 here is what? 2. So we drop down 2. Okay, so this is our answer, 21,546. So you understand how to what? Multiply. Okay, so for you to know when you have several steps, it's on the second digit multiplying. Okay, you can see here, this is just one step because you just have one number, 7, just multiplying this. Okay, you can see also it happened here that when you have a 2-step that you have to add up, we have 2 numbers multiplying the upper one. Okay, so let's do a word problem here before we end this video. Okay, so let's, we have a word problem that says, sorry, I have to erase all this here. It says Susan has $5 bills. Okay, no, so it says Susan has 35 bills. 30. How much money does she have in total? Susan has $35 bills. It's just like having $5 bills 30 times. So how much, what's the total money she has? It's just simply, this is a word problem. It's just simply telling you to what? Multiply what? The $5 bills times what? 30. So we have what? 30 times what? 5. Okay? So here we have 5 times 0, which is what? 0. And what is 5 times 3, which is what? 15. So we have 150 what? Dollars. Don't forget your dollar sign. Okay? Because this question can just come out in your test and you just be given a line to write down your answer. So don't forget your dollar sign, $150. Okay, so thank you for staying to the end of this video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, give this video a thumbs up, and also share this video with your friends, family, and loved ones. So from us, from DTW GED Prep, you are destined to win. See you in our next video.